Белозеров и чрезвычайный полномочный посол Республики Индии в Российской Федерации П.С. Ракхван подписывают меморандум о взаимопонимании между ОАО РЖД и Министерством железных дорог Республики Индии в отношении технического сотрудничества в железнодорожной сфере.
Memorandum of Understanding between the Ministry of Railways of the Republic of India and the joint stock company Russian Railways on technical cooperation in railway sector, signed by Mr. Oleg Belozerov, President of Russian Railways, and Ambassador of India, Mr. P.S. Raghavan.
Председатель правления Открытого акционерного общества «Нефтяная компания Роснефть» Игорь Иванович Сечин и управляющий директор компании ONGC Видыш Лимитед Нарендра Верма подписывают соглашение о подтверждении успешного завершения первой этапа подготовки к закрытию сделки по созданию совместного предприятия на базе акционерного общества «Ванкорнефть» и меморандум о взаимопонимании по вопросам сотрудничества в области геологических изысканий, поиска разведочных работ и добычи углеводородов на суше и на континентальном шельфе Российской Федерации.
Memorandum of Understanding for Cooperation of Geologic Survey, Exploration and Production of Hydrocarbons onshore and on the continental shelf of the Russian Federation, and confirmation of successful completion of the first stage pre-completion actions in relation to the creation of a joint venture in JSC Ventures. Signed by Mr. Igor Sechin, CEO Rosneft, and Sri Narendra Verma, MD, ONGC Videsh Limited.
Председатель правления Открытого акционерного общества «Нефтяная компания Роснефть» Игорь Иванович Сечин, председатель компании «Oil India Limited» Упендра Прасад Сингх и председатель компании «Indian Oil Corporation Limited» Биш Ашок подписывают меморандум о взаимопонимании по вопросам сотрудничества в области геологических изысканий, поисково-разведочных работ и добычи углеводородов на суше Российской Федерации.
Memorandum of Understanding for Cooperation of Geologic Survey, Exploration and Production of Hydrocarbons onshore, the Russian Federation between Rosneft Oil Company, Oil India Limited and Indian Oil Corporation Limited, signed by Mr. Igor Sechin and Upendra Prasad for Oil India and for Indian Oil, Mr. B. Ashok.
Президент Российской Федерации Владимир Владимирович Путин и премьер-министр Республики Индии Нарендра Моди приняли совместное российско-индийское заявление по итогам официального визита в Российскую Федерацию премьер-министра Республики Индии Нарендры Моди через доверительные отношения к новым горизонтам сотрудничества.
From the media, both the leaders have adopted a joint statement that trust new horizons today. We will now have a press statement.
Завершению первый официальный визит в Москву премьер-министра Индии господина Нарендра Моди. Наши переговоры были очень содержательными и плодотворными. Надеюсь, что они будут способствовать дальнейшему продвижению особо привилегированного российско-индийского стратегического партнерства. Вчера еще мы с господином Моди провели отдельную неформальную встречу, на которой содействие процессу национального примирения в Афганистане, убеждены, что в интересах всего мирового сообщества формирование широкой антитеррористической коалиции, действующей на основе международного права и под эгидой Организации Объединенных Наций. Россия выступает за дальнейшее усиление роли Индии в решении глобальных и региональных проблем. Считаем, что Индия, как великая держава, проводящая взвешенный и ответственный внешнеполитический курс, является одним из наиболее достойных кандидатов на место постоянного члена Совета Безопасности ООН. Напомню также, что Россия активно поддержала присоединение Индии к Шанхайской организации сотрудничества. Мы тесно взаимодействуем в рамках БРИКС, председательство в котором передадим индийским партнерам в феврале 2016 года. В ходе сегодняшних переговоров в узком и в широком составах, а также на встрече с ведущими индийскими и российскими бизнесменами, говорили о развитии всего комплекса двухсторонних отношений. Особое внимание уделили торгово-экономическому сотрудничеству. К сожалению, в январе-октябре текущего года взаимный товарооборот уменьшился на 14,4%. В основном это связано со снижением цен на
энергоснабжение, из-за
Договорились активизировать усилия, чтобы вывести торговлю на траекторию устойчивого роста. Детально обсудили практические меры по развитию и
диверсификации товарооборота. Ключевую роль в этой работе играет Международная комиссия.
Это, конечно, наращивание
Stepping up our investment cooperation is an important reserve that we have. We have agreed to increase our mutual investment flows by deepening industrial cooperation, carrying out major infrastructure and energy projects. With Russia's assistance, Kudankulam nuclear power station has been built. The first power unit of this plant was commissioned in June 2014. Just a few weeks are left before the second power unit is commissioned. We intend to start building the third and the fourth units in the near future. We're also negotiating the fifth and the sixth power units. We've achieved an agreement that the Indian side will provide one more site for the construction of Russian-designed power units.
And
the state-of-the-art pressure 1200 will be used with the most advanced and secure and safe technological solutions. These are practical steps that we take to implement a very important document that we signed a year ago, Strategic Vision of Cooperation in the Use of Atomic Energy. This document contains our plans to construct at least six additional nuclear power plants units in India within the next 20 years. The export of Russian hydrocarbons to India is growing. Under the agreement between the Rosneft company and Essar company, there are plans for large-scale supply of oil and oil products to Indian refineries in the amount of 10 million tons per year during 10 years. This year, Gazprom has exported 5 big lots of liquefied natural gas to India. Major projects have been implemented in thermal and hydro energy. The power machines company has concluded the supply of machinery and commissioned equipment for Terry and Ballymella hydropower plants and for Kanasima power plant. The construction of 3 units of Sipat power plant has been constructed on the turnkey basis. However, large-scale business ties of Russia and India go far beyond that energy. I would like to emphasize our strategic cooperation in the diamonds industry. Russia is the biggest diamond extracting country in the world. 27% of extraction. India is the leader in terms of cutting diamonds, 65% of production, almost 50% of Russian rough diamonds go to India. Last year, during our joint participation in the World Diamond Conference that took place in New Delhi, together with Mr. Modi, we have agreed to further step up our cooperation. We're doing this work. In particular, the Alrosa company has increased the number of long-term contracts from 9 to 12. To broaden our cooperation, we're building a special notified zone at the Para Diamond Vault. We've also agreed to launch new joint projects in crop industry, metallurgy, pharmaceuticals, chemical industry. We've discussed the prospects of the participation of Russian business in the implementation of the Make in India import substitution program. We see it as an additional opportunity to create joint enterprises to transfer technologies to produce goods with high added value. And we also believe that the protocol that we signed on simplification of requirements for mutual travels of certain categories of citizens of two countries will galvanize business ties and liberalize the visa regime. Now businessmen will be able to visit Russia and India upon direct invitations of partners. Our countries have been traditionally closely working on military and military-technical cooperation, and I'm referring not only to the supply of products, but also to a close technological cooperation. The benchmark for such cooperation is the joint development of BrahMos missile systems. The large-scale production of anti-vessel missiles in the interest of Indian naval forces was launched. Just as much promising are projects of multi-role fighters and multi-role transport aircraft. We have emphasized the importance of regular ground, naval, and air military exercises in drone. Another important element of the Russian-Indian partnership is, of course, and has always been, humanitarian ties. This year, Russians have shown a great interest in the Festival of Indian Culture. We hope that the Festival of Russian Culture that will take place in India next year will be just as much memorable for our friends. And in conclusion, I would love to thank our Indian colleagues and friends, and in particular Mr. Modi, for the constructive joint work. We will continue doing everything possible to develop the Russian-Indian partnership for the benefit of our countries and nations. Thank you very much for your attention.
Your Excellency, President Vladimir Putin, members of the media, let me begin by expressing my deepest condolence on the loss of lives in the terrorist attack on a civilian Russian aircraft and in the unfortunate downing of the military in Syria. In this moment of grief and challenge, we stand in solidarity with the people of Russia. Mr. President, thank you for generous and warm hospitality. You are the architect of the India-Russia strategic partnership. And in changing world, your leadership has kept our relations on a steady course of progress and growth. Mr. President, I have always had great respect and appreciation for your strategic partnership. It has been a source of strength and success for India in defense, development, and diplomacy. And the genuine goodwill and mutual respect between our people. As I look to the future, significant information and in shaping of a balanced, stable, inclusive, and a multipolar. I have had excellent conversation . It has deepened my conviction that this relationship truly meets the test of a special and privileged strategic partnership. We have laid the foundation of the future character of this strategic partnership. The intergovernmental agreement on manufacture of Komo-226 helicopter in India is the first project for a make in India mission. It is rightly with our most important defense partner. We have made progress on a number of other defense proposals. This would boost defense manufacturing in India and India's defense readiness with next generation equipments. The pace of our cooperation in nuclear energy is increasing. We are making progress on our plans for 12 Russian nuclear reactors at two sites. The agreement today will increase Indian manufacturing content in these reactors. It supports my mission of Make in India. I thank President Putin for his support. With one of the world's largest reserves of hydrocarbons, Russia can be a critical source of energy security for India, especially because of our strategic partnership. With President Putin's support, we are enlarging Indian investment in Russian hydrocarbon sector. President Putin and I are moving creatively in expanding our economic relations. Following our last summit, India has created a special notified joint to facilitate direct world uncut diamond exporter, Russia and India, which process 90% of the world's uncut diamond. Second, we are working on logistics. Our Green Corridor project has taken on the international north-south transport transit corridor through Iran, Third, we are moving forward on the India-Eurasian Economic Union Free Trade Agreement. This will also benefit us in Central Asia. Fourth, we are encouraging our private sector to connect with each other more. We have just had an excellent meeting of CEO Forum. The agreements and the announcements today give me confidence that we will see huge increase in investments and trade in both directions. President Putin and I have high degree of convergence in our position on global issues and a strong commitment to deepen our international cooperation. We have a strong collaboration in the United Nations. Our membership of BRICS, East Asia Summit, G20, a global capital. It is particularly important in the arc of Eurasia to Asia Pacific, including in Central Asia and Afghanistan. We are one in our belief that the world must unite and take considered action on combating terrorism without distinction and discrimination between terrorist group and target countries. We agree that an early political settlement through dialogue in West Asia is essential for restoring stability and containing extremism in the region. Indeed, all nations must come together with sensitivity to each other to address the challenge of our times. I am very pleased to have deepened my association with President Putin. Together, we have also given new direction and added more momentum and content to our strategic partnership. Just as I have had a pleasure of visiting Russia twice this year, I look forward to welcoming President Putin in India next year for the BRICS summit as well as the annual summit. Thank you.